The other half of what we can do.
All right.
You've got that grid.
Okay.
And you know, getting both of them is the key.
Yeah.
You know, music isn't written to formulate for our technique. So you can't shove the music onto the technique. You have to make the technique work to make the music. So you have to make adjustments and be flexible. You know, real playing, advanced playing, is knowing all the rules and knowing how to break them successfully.
Every time I have one built, I have them build it with more bass notes. I have a bass envy, I think. I just want more bass strings.
Just like we did with the other techniques, if you can do that, why not? All right? I have two fingers for you, right? Why not play one harmonic note and two? Two notes. For each fret, I go up with my left hand.
To rest the thumb though when you use the nail. I mean, it's easier when you use the fleshy part, it's easier to rest it, you know,
to rest. To do a rest stroke with your thumb, is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
When I do rest stroke with my thumb, I have to bring my wrist out a little bit.
You still use the nail?
I do use rest stroke with my thumb. Yeah, actually, there was an article about John Williams about 20 years ago where he said he did rest stroke with his thumb a lot.
Because the guitar, I think, is one of the most physically demanding instruments there is. It's not a piano where you get a kid can go up to a piano and make sound. And it would be pretty close to the sound that a maestro would make, except it's just, you know, one note. Try having somebody who just walk off the street and make like a good sound on a guitar. It ain't gonna happen. It won't happen. So because of the athletic quality of being a guitar player, you gotta bring, you know, think about that and try to complete the circle of your body, mind, flexibility, and strength.
Okay,
now we switch.
Oh, so it's guitar. I gotta use this as a whole different story, man. Oh my god.
It's really a different story.
Can I tell him how much these are?
Just play. It's a lot.
It is an elegy for a lute patron, a count, who funded and befriended all the lute players of the time. When he died, it said that all the lute players put their instruments down for a week. They wouldn't play.
Just push-ups alone, sets it to, you know, whatever, 10, will pump the blood into you, get the oxygen flowing, and allow you to stretch better. That's another thing. You don't want to stretch right away. You want to do something to get your blood moving before you actually stretch the muscle.
Well,
some can, some do it better than others, and some are lying.
And at the same time, it's not awful. Again, this becomes your conscious choice. You're the artist. I mean, the Alexander technique is a means to be able to help you use it, but as the artist, you want to do what you need to do. You know, if somebody is playing a hunchback, they're not going to go on with a straight spine on stage. You know, they've got to be able to use the technique within it.
Pacific Ocean. Yeah, sorry.
Wait, what's the point of that?
Georgie!